लेसन वन, मैटर इन आवर सराउंडिंग्स, मैटर एंड इट्स फिजिकल नेचर। हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दिस चैप्टर। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज मैटर। यू कैन सी वेरियस ऑब्जेक्ट्स अराउंड योर सेल्फ लाइक टेबल, चेयर, फूड, वाटर। व्हाट इज कॉमन इन ऑल दीज थिंग्स? ऑल दीज थिंग्स ऑक्यूपाई स्पेस एंड हैज मास। Examples of matter: water we drink, food we eat, air we breathe, clothes we wear are all examples from our daily life are examples of matter. Anything that occupies space and has mass is called matter. Matter can be identified or felt with our senses. For example, we cannot see air, but we can feel it. We can feel heat, electricity, emotions, beauty, sorrow, thoughts and ideas also, but therefore not considered as matter because they do not acquire any space and has mass. Important properties of matter is it occupies space and has mass. Matter can be classified on the basis of their physical properties, that is, matter is can be classified into three states, that is, solid, liquid and gas. On the basis of their chemical properties, matter can be classified into element, compounds and mixtures. Physical nature of matter is it is made up of extremely small particles. The characteristics of particles of matter are: number one, particles of matter have space between them. For understanding this, we have to perform an activity. Take a 100 ml beaker, fill half the beaker with water and put a mark on the level of the water. Dissolve some salt or sugar with the help of a glass rod. Observe any change in water level. Sugar is made up of extremely small particles. On stirring, they further break into more smaller particles. These extremely small particles go into spaces between the various particles of water, due to which there is no change in the volume of water. On dissolving sugar in it, this proves that particles of water, which is matter, have space between them. The next characteristic of particle of matter is that the particles of matter are extremely small in size. To understand this, we have to perform an activity. Take 2-3 crystals of potassium permanganate and dissolve them in 100 ml of water. Mark this beaker A. Now take out approximately 10 ml of this solution and put it into 90 ml of clear water and mark this beaker as B. Take out 10 ml of the solution and put it into another 90 ml of clear water and keep diluting the solution like this 5 to 8 times. Is the water still clear colored? Yes. This experiment shows that just a few crystals of potassium permanganate can color a large volume of water. We conclude that one crystal of potassium permanganate is made up of millions of very tiny particles which keep on dividing themselves into smaller and smaller particles. On dissolving in water, and the color of solution of potassium permanganate gets lighter. Therefore, we can say that particles of matter are extremely small in size. The next characteristic of particles of matter is it is continuously moving. To understand this, we have to perform an activity. Put a unlit incense stick in a corner of your room. How close do you have to go near it so as to get its smell? Now light the incense stick What happens? Do you get the smell sitting at a distance? We get the smell of this incense stick sitting at a distance because the burning incense stick produces vapors having pleasant smell which move rapidly in all directions. When the gaseous particles from the incense stick reach our nose, with air we can smell the fragrance. This shows that the fragrance of a burning incense stick spread in the entire room very quickly. It tells us that the particles of matter are continuously moving. If the particle of gases produced particles by the burning of incense stick were not moving, then the fragrance of incense stick could not be spread in the whole room. The next characteristic of particle of matter is that it is continuously moving, and the movement of particles increases with increase in temperature. The next characteristic is particles of matter attract each other with the forces of attraction, and the strength of this force of attraction varies from one kind of matter to another. To find this, we have to take three samples, that is a chalk, a rubber band and an iron nail. Try breaking them by hammering, cutting or stretching. In which of the three substances do you think the particles are held together with greater force? We find that it is very easy to break a piece of chalk into smaller pieces. It requires more force to break a rubber band, whereas the iron nail does not break at all with the large force. This shows that the particles of iron nail are held together with the stronger forces of attraction than in rubber band and in chalk piece. Therefore, it is very difficult to break the iron nail. The particles of chalk piece are held together by comparatively weaker forces of attraction. So, what do we conclude? That the characteristics of particles of matter are: the particles of matter are extremely small in size, they have space between them, they attract each other, and they are continuously in motion. The properties on these physical properties of matter, it is classified into three categories. They are solid, liquids and gases. First, we are going to study about the properties of solids. Solids, the particles are closely and compactly packed. The particles are held together through strong forces of attraction between them. The particles have negligible kinetic energy. Solids have definite shape and volume. What about sugar and salt? When kept in different jars, these take the space of the jar, hence they are solid. Sugar and salt have very tiny crystals, and they are considered to be solids because the shape of individual crystals of salt and sugar remain fixed whether we take it in our hands, put it in a place or in a jar. Solids are generally rigid in nature and cannot change their shape. They have a tendency to maintain their shape when subjected to outside force. Then what about a rubber band? Can it change its shape on stretching? Is it a solid? A rubber band can be stretched by applying force. However, when the force is removed, the rubber band regains its original shape. The property is called elasticity. If excessive force is applied, it breaks. Solids may break under force, but it is difficult their shape difficult to change their shape, so they are rigid. The same property shown by spring. Solids cannot be compressed under normal conditions. Then what about sponge? It is solid, yet we are able to compress it. Why? A sponge has minute holes in which air is trapped. When we press it, The air is expelled out and we are able to compress it. The next property of solid is, solids have high densities, they are heavy. Solids do not flow. The particles of solids have negligible kinetic energy because particles need space to move, which is not there in case of solids as they are closely packed, so they do not move freely. Solids not fill their container completely. Solids have strong forces of attraction which binds the particles to stay together, and hence solids have fixed shape and volume. Properties of liquids. The properties of liquids are, liquids are loosely packed and space between the particles is slightly more than that in solids. The particles are held together through a weaker force of attraction between them as compared to solids. The particles have higher kinetic energy as compared to solids. Now, the detailed properties of liquids. Liquids have no fixed shape but have a fixed volume. Liquids take up the shape of the container in which they are kept. Liquids can flow easily, so they are called fluids. Liquids can change their shape and are not rigid. Liquids have lesser density than solids but have higher density as compared to gas. The particles of liquids have higher kinetic energy as compared to solids because the force of attraction is comparatively weaker than solids. Liquids cannot be compressed much as solids. Liquids do not fill the container completely. Liquids do not have strong forces of attraction like solids that binds the particles to stay together, but have enough force of attraction between the particles to keep the volume fixed. So liquids have a fixed volume, therefore liquids do not fill the container completely. The properties of gases. The particles are very loosely packed and the space between the particles is more than that in liquids and solids. The particles are held together through a force of attraction between them, which is weakest among all the three states. The particles have higher kinetic energy as compared to liquids and solids. Gases have neither a fixed shape nor a fixed volume. Gases acquire the shape and the volume of the container in which they are kept. Gases can be compressed easily.
Due to high compressibility in gases,
large volume of gases can be compressed into small cylinders and transported easily. For example, LPG, liquefied petroleum gas, cylinders that we get in our home for cooking contains compressed petroleum gas. The oxygen cylinders that we get in hospitals for patients contain compressed natural gas. CNG, compressed natural gas, is used as fuels these days in vehicles. Gases have very low densities. They are very, very light. A gas is much lighter than the same volume of a solid or liquid. Gases fill their containers completely because of weaker force of attraction between the particles and more space between the particles. Gases flow easily, so they are called fluids. Particles of gases have higher kinetic energy than solids and liquids. The intermixing of particles of two different types of matter on their own is called diffusion. In diffusion, particles of one type of matter intermix with other type of matter by getting into the spaces between the particles of matter. Solids generally do not show diffusion in solids because the particles have negligible space between them and have very less kinetic energy. Some solids like copper sulfate, crystals, salt, sugar, etc. show diffusion in liquids, as there are some solids like camphor and dry ice which show diffusion in gases.